works. At least I think it does. Hello? Hello? Who the hell is that? Who the hell's in this picture here? Hello? Who is this?
This is your operator.
Operator? Well, what do you want?
I beg your pardon?
You called? You must want something.
You called me, sir.
Oh, that was a long time ago. You never answered.
Well, we get a little busy.
I see. Well, here you are. How are you?
Great.
How nice. Listen, this is Norman Thayer, Jr., Professor Emeritus, University of Pennsylvania, Department of English, over on Golden Pond.
Where are you?
Golden Pond.
Where exactly?
In New England, dear, in the state of Maine.
No, where exactly in Maine?
Well, where are you?
Oh, I'm in Waterville.
Oh, I thought so. You have that accent, you know.
Well, it doesn't sound like it to me.
Well, it doesn't matter. Golden Pond is very near wherever you are.
Okie dokie.
Look, there's something I would like you to do if you could. Call me up. Can you do that?
Is there some reason I'm doing it?
I want to check my phone to make certain it rings. It hasn't been rung all winter, as far as we know. It may have lost its whatsie.
We'll give it a test then.
Oh, thank you very much. Do you have my number?
Oh, we would need that.
Yes, you would, I would think.
You can just read it to me. It's written on the phone.
What do you mean, written on the phone? There's nothing written on the... Oh, I see what you mean. Oh, but I can't read that. No, sorry. Too small. They should make those numbers bigger. You'll have to look it up, dear.
What's the exchange?
Well, I haven't a clue. There's a 9 in it. That's all I know.
Well, there's a lot of numbers with 9s in them.
Well, I suppose there are a lot of numbers with 9s. You'll have to look it up. You must have a book. Norman Thayer, Jr., State of Maine.
I'll call you back.
Thank you very much. Now, who the hell is that? Somebody's at the door.
It's me, you poke! Oh.
Look at you.
Yes, quite a sight.
Where are you?
In the woods.
In the woods? How nice.
It's beautiful. Everything's waking up. Little tiny leaves. Little tiny birds. I saw 3 chippies and a whole patch of little flowers out by the old well hole. And millions of black flies. My hair, my eyes, just terrible.
Well, what were you doing out there in the woods?
Well, getting kindling.
Oh.
Oh, just look at this place.
Yeah, it's a mess, isn't it?
Oh, no. It'll be just all shipshape in just a couple of minutes. Here, help me with these covers. What happened to the screen door?
Fell over.
How?
Pushed it.
What do you mean?
I pushed the door and the door fell over.
Well, it's not supposed to do that.
Well, I didn't think so. I'll fix it later.
Well, you might have closed the big door.
Oh, I didn't dare. I was afraid of what might happen.
Now I'll be swatting at black flies for the next 2 days. The room is probably full of them.
Well, I don't see any.
Well, you don't see them. Well, it's too late. But they're not as bad on the lakeside. No, not when it's windy and there's whitecaps today. You're helping this. I met a very nice couple.
What? Where?
In the woods.
You met a couple in the woods? A couple of people?
No, a couple of antelope. Of course, a couple of people. You need to be too careful with these. Going to hang them out on the
people doing in the woods?
Oh, they were walking. Their name is Melchiorin or something like that.
Melchiorin? What sort of a name is that?
I don't know, dear. Probably Italian.
They're up in Boston.
Oh, they speak English?
Of course they speak English. How do you think I spoke to them? Here, help me with this. They're a very nice middle-aged couple, just like us.
If they're just like us, they're not middle-aged.
Of course they are.
Middle age means middle, Ethel. The middle of life. People don't live to be 150.
We're just at the far edge, that's all.
We're not, you know. We're not middle-aged. You're old, and I'm ancient.
Oh, pooh. You're in your 70s, and I'm in my 60s.
Just barely on both ends.
Well, are we going to spend the afternoon quibbling about this?
Well, we can if you like.
Well, man, what your age group. The Melchiorins have invited us up to dinner. Oh, no, I wanted to tell you that they're staying at the Putnams. You know, well, the Putnams are in Europe.
You know Putnams, don't
you? Oh, yes, they do. They're the best of friends. That's what Mrs. Melchior said.
Ha ha.
And they did invite us up to dinner.
Oh, well, my stomach isn't ready for rigatoni and that sort of thing. A tiramisu.
We didn't discuss the menu.
Oh,
help me with these rugs.
Oh.
Guess who else I ran into in the woods?
You met somebody else in the woods?
Boy,
the woods are full of people.
Yes, it was just Charlie.
Who's Charlie?
Charlie the mailman.
Well, what was Charlie the mailman doing in the woods?
Oh, no, he was on the road.
You were on the road too? You didn't say that. You said you were in the woods.
Well, the road runs through the woods, you know?
Oh, well, of course.
Well, Charlie wants to put in our dock.
What for?
To park the boat beside.
I'll put in the dock.
You won't put in the dock.
Why not?
Because you're too old.
I'm not old at all. I'm middle-aged.
But old Pearson has been putting in the dock for God knows how long anyways. And he died this winter. So Charlie offered to do it for us. Now that old Pearson has met his just reward.
Well, how did that come about?
Well, I don't know, dear. Perhaps he got old.
No, I mean, how did the subject of our duck come about?
Oh. Well. Oh. Charlie said that he wouldn't be delivering mail for another 2 weeks. And by boat, you know. So he wanted to make sure that we were okay. He must be the busiest man in the state of Maine.
Well, I certainly would think so. He's certainly the dimmest witted.
Norman.
Oh, I've known Charlie since he was a little fella.
Yes.
Little blonde-haired kid. He would laugh at anything. That was then when I thought he was a bit deficient. Charlie must be 30 by now.
Charlie is 44. He's 2 years older than Chelsea.
Chelsea is 42? Our Chelsea?
Afraid so.
Good God! What do you think?
Oh, quite a sight.
Ah, I thought so. How's that table? A bit heavy?
Yes. My father made this table. It's nearly as old as the house.
Your father made that?
Yes, the first year I went to Camp Puchakaya. Charlie said that Miss Ackley probably won't make it up this year.
Who's Miss Appley?
Miss Appley, Norman, lives with Miss Tate.
Oh. How about this one?
Oh, stunning. They must be in their 90s by now. They were up here when I was a teenager, wearing their neckties and singing in the gazebo, holding hands. What a marvelous love affair. Can you imagine being with somebody that long?
No.
Thanks a lot. Charlie says that Miss Appley is just too frail, and Miss Tate won't come without her. One of them has a nephew, I think, who'll get the house. It's sad, isn't it? Oh, poor Elmer. He's got a terrible fall.
Who's poor Elmer?
Elmer, my doll. He fell in the fireplace.
Oh.
He's nearly 65 years old this spring. Can you imagine?
No, I wasn't aware of that.
I got him for my 4th birthday. I remember it quite clearly. I wanted a red scooter, but my father said that red scooters were contrary to the ways of the Lord and they were excessive. He said that I would understand when I got older. Well, I'm a lot older now and I still don't understand. But he got me Elmer. The times we had. Do you know he was my first true love?
Oh, well, I don't think there's any need for you to review the wanderings of your youth. I realized all along I wasn't the first in line.
No, you were just a cheap substitute for my darling Elmer. 65 years old. It's hard to think of a doll as being old. He doesn't look that much different. He's a bit faded, perhaps. He'd still be a delight to any small child. Chelsea used to love him. And now he's had a fall, you poor dear.
Maybe he wanted to kill himself. Maybe he wants to be cremated. Probably has cancer or termites or something.
Would you please shut up? I swear you become more morbid every year.
Well, it would be a bad way to go when you think about it. Quick flip off the front mantle. Little kick at the end, land in the fire. Nothing to it.
Norman, are you hungry?
Nope. When my number's up, do that for me, would you? Prop me up on the mantle and point out which direction is down. May even shoot for a full gaiter and a half twist.
Norma!
It's that little kick at the end that's got me worried. You could get Charlie and hoist me up again if I should make a mess of it.
Norman!
Maybe 3 tries will go with the highest score. Well, I'll be pretty well dead anyway after 3 full gaiters and a half twist. And if I haven't managed to hit the fire, on the 3rd go, you can give me a bit of a nudge.
Norman, you really are becoming a nitwit, aren't you?
I think I'll have that written in the final instructions of my will. Let's call up that Jewish person in Wilmington. See how much he'd charge for a rewrite. You wouldn't even need to get an urn. You could just shovel me out when I'm done and dump me on your flowers.
Your fascination with death is beginning to frazzle my good humor.
That might be Charlotte now.
Haven't you got anything?
I don't know. We've been pooped out yet.
Haven't you got anything else to think about?
Nothing quite as interesting.
Well, then why don't you go ahead and take your dive and get it over with. See
and
what
leave
it's like.
You? And leave you with poor Elmer? You must be mad. I've heard all those widow stories. Your souls are going to answer that.
Yes. Hello? Hello? There's no one there.
Aha! See?
Hello?
I'm here. I really am.
Oh, hello.
Is this the Norman Thayer Jr. residence?
Yes.
Is Norman Thayer Jr. there?
Just a moment, please. It's for you.
Who is it?
I don't know.
It's not St. Peter, is it? Hello? Who is this?
It's your operator.
It's the operator. What do you want?
You asked me to call.
I don't think so. Oh, to check the ring, of course. Well, I've given up on you. Does it work?
You tell me.
Well, yes, it does. Now that I think about it, it did ring. That's why we picked up. Oh, everything's hunky-dory then.
As far as I'm concerned.
Great. Thank you.
Have a nice day.
I beg your pardon?
Have a nice day.
Oh. She said, have a nice day. What a strange thing to say. What did she think I was going to do? Phone works.
Good. What about these fish poles? Have you been through them this year?
Oh, I doubt if I'll be doing any fishing this time around.
All right.
It's a shame they charge you money for the license.
Oh, no.
You would think that they would give an old case like me free. It isn't as though I go out and deplete the entire trout population or something.
You always get your share. You always have.
Well, those days are behind me now.
All right, Norman.
Who the hell's in this picture here?
What picture?
Here. This fat woman with a fat baby.
That is Millie's daughter, Jane, and her grandson. But I don't know his name.
Who's Millie?
Millie, Norman, our next door neighbor in Wilmington.
Oh, so that's her name. Well, there's certainly a family resemblance through the generations, isn't there? Everybody's fat. Chelsea, on the swim team at school. Not exactly thin.
She had a few fat years.
Well, it's no wonder she couldn't do a backflip. No center of gravity.
Well, she tried, Norman.
Yes, I know. I remember.
She only did it for you anyways. She only wanted to please you.
Yep.
Maybe this year we could persuade her to come and spend a few days. Wouldn't that be nice?
How about a game of parcheesi?
Not right now, Norman.
I guess you wouldn't be up for some Monopoly then, huh?
Maybe tonight, Norman. We've got the whole summer. The whole summer for you to try and figure out how to win back the oodles of money you lost to me last year. I hope you've thought about some of your tactics over the winter.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty shoddy, some of those moves of yours. It's so good to be home.
Mm-hmm.
We've got the whole summer. Norman!
What?
The loons! I've spotted the loon!
Where?
Oh, bring the glasses.
Oh.
Lord, now, get out there. Aren't they lovely? Can you see them?
Oh. Oh, there they are.
Oh my goodness.
They're huge. I've never seen loons so big in my life.
Those are boats, you poop. Come down lower, by the float.
Oh, there they are.
Black.
Look at them swimming about.
Black and sleek, aren't they lovely birds?
How wonderful.
Norman, they're looking at us. They
think they're talking.
Yes.
And I didn't. Yeah, you know, but I can't make out what they're saying. Can you read, Beaks?
Oh. They're kissing is what they're doing.
How wonderful.
Do you realize that this is our 48th summer together, Norman? Our 48th summer on Golden Pond.
Probably our last.
Shut up!
One, listen. Driver wanted for occasional errands and chauffeuring. 5 days a week. Pay negotiable. Sounds about right, huh? Experience required. Well, I've driven enough cars, God knows. How many cars would you say I've had? 20, probably? Not counting the Saturn? 20 cars and one Saturn. Sounds like enough experience. I think I'll give these people a call, huh? What? There's no number. Oh, for God's sakes. So typical. They want somebody for a job and they don't even list the number. Well, I hope those errands weren't too crucial. Good God! Somebody's at the door.
It's me, you fool. Open up.
What are you doing up there?
Picking berries. There's oodles and oodles of little strawberries out by the old town road. See?
Oh, aren't they nice?
Unfortunately, there's oodles and oodles of mosquitoes, too. Worse this year than ever.
Well, I haven't noticed any.
You've barely been outside. What you're doing inside on a day like today is beyond me.
Oh, I've been quite busy, you know. I've been checking yesterday's paper for gainful employment.
Oh, here we go again.
There were some pretty good prospects, you know. Chauffeuring, yard work. Dairy Divine wants an ice cream dipper. I think that's something I can do, don't you? Oh, hello? Oh! What do you think?
I think this nonsense, if you looking at the classified, is about the silliest thing I've ever heard. What are you going to do if someone answers your call and they tell you to come over and start tomorrow?
I'll go over and start tomorrow.
For the love of God, whatever is the matter with you? I'll tell you what. Why don't you go pick us another quart of those berries, and I'll make us up a scrumptious shortcake for lunch.
You want me to pick strawberries?
Yes, do I have to put an ad in the paper?
I don't think I know how to pick strawberries.
It's really very easy, Norman. You just bend over and pick them.
Bend over? What on earth for? Where are they?
They're on the ground where they belong.
Oh, oh God. Your buckets are full of them.
Don't move.
Well, here comes what's his name? strawberries.
I'll pay you, Norman. This could be the beginning of something big. You might become a major strawberry picker.
Not if I have to be bending over all the time. I think you're trying to kill me.
I thought about it.
Well, you needn't bother. I'm on borrowed time as it is.
Would you please take your cheery personality and get out of here?
Maybe I'll lie down and pick the berries.
Would you go on?
Where did you say these berries were? Other than on the ground, I mean?
Out on the Old Town Road, just across from the Met.
Coffee,
Norman?
No.
neck and ring. Lift it out of the porch.
Well, you think you could get it? Could you do that?
You bet.
Watch out for the mosquitoes.
Would you like a glass of milk, Norman?
No. I'll get you one. I see you broke the screen door, Charlie.
Well, yeah, it's just missing little thingamabobbers for the hinges.
I don't know about that. It was working all right. You must have yanked on it.
Well, yeah.
Come on, let's have a meal.
I got a package for you.
Oh.
Here, drink this.
Thank you, nurse.
Sit down, Charlie.
I should get going, I guess, or somebody's not going to get the mail.
He's right, Ethel. Neither rain or sleet or hot biscuits and all that.
Sit down, Charlie, and finish your coffee. What have you got there, Norman?
I don't know. I can't open it. Here, bite this, please.
Well, what is it?
I don't know.
Oh, it's your medicine, just in time.
Oh, goody. What a swell surprise.
Oh, you've nearly run out. It's nothing serious, Charlie. It's just for his palpitations.
That's right, Charlie. I have occasional heart throbs. There's a bill from Gas and Power in Wilmington, and we're not even there.
It's only a little bit each month.
Well, here, you give that back to them. Being that you are the mailman, you can deliver all of this to the old lady down here. I'm going to read the paper. I've got to need a little touch with reality.
Oh, there's a letter from Chelsea here.
I noticed that. How is she? Norman?
What?
Chelsea.
Who?
Your daughter, Chelsea.
What about her?
How is she?
Oh, 42.
How is she?
I don't know. You'll have to ask her mother.
Ethel?
Mm.
How is she?
Mm-hmm.
Is she really 42, Norman?
Who?
Is Chelsea really 42?
That's what her mother says.
Holy macaroni, she went all the way through and never had kids, huh?
What do you mean, all the way through?
Her childbearing years.
Oh, I suppose.
She sounds as if she's having the best time.
That's great.
Those damn Red Sox.
Where's she writing from? I couldn't make out the postmark.
What?
Where's Chelsea writing from?
Home.
Well, yeah, I figured that. Where's she live now?
At home. Those damn Yankees.
Oh, this is wonderful. Lives on the coast, Charlie.
Oh.
You better tell him which coast, or he'll think she's living in Bar Harbor. California, Charlie.
I knew that.
He knew that.
Damn Orioles. Baltimore is such a sneaky town.
Oh, Norman. She says she's coming for your birthday. And she's bringing her friend. She has the nicest boyfriend, Charlie.
Oh.
She decided all on her own? No help from anyone?
What? What are you saying?
Likely story, Mrs. Machiavelli.
They're coming together as part of a vacation. Then they're going on to Europe.
Well, I don't want crowds of people here on my birthday. I don't want crowds of people watching me turn older.
There's only the three of us. Is three a crowd?
That's what they say.
That's right. Three's a crowd. What happened to her husband?
Wait a minute. This is not that Freddy person. This is a different boyfriend altogether.
What the hell is going on? Detroit disappeared. They're gone completely. Good God!
What is it, Norman?
Detroit is gone. This stupid paper. dropped from the league? Well, that stupid commissioner, anything is possible.
What happened to her husband?
Oh, my goodness.
What?
Well, what did you say, Charlie?
I wondered what happened to Chelsea's husband.
Oh, he didn't work out.
He couldn't tell the difference between a Negro and an Italian.
What?
The stupid commissioner. Talking about the so-called greats of the 20th century. He's got DiMaggio mixed up with Henry Aaron.
Oh, my goodness.
And boy, that's a hard mistake to make. It's a good thing he wasn't in charge during the war. He would have invaded Newark, looking for Mussolini. That wasn't a joke, Charlie.
She said she is in love with a dentist.
Oh, really? Does her boyfriend know?
That is her new boyfriend. Her new boyfriend is a dentist.
That's interesting.
That's whom she's bringing here? A dentist?
Yes.
Huh.
Oh, God. You'll be staring at our teeth all the time. Why does she have this fascination for Jewish people?
Who says this one is Jewish?
Well, he's a dentist, isn't he? Name me one dentist who isn't Jewish.
Your brother.
But he's deceased. Name me one living dentist who isn't Jewish.
Dr. Baylor.
Who's Dr. Baylor?
My dentist.
He's in Maine, Charlie. There are no Jews in Maine.
Well, sure there are. The Gittermans up in Spruce Cove.
Those are tourists. Most tourists are Jewish.
I know a Jewish guy who's not a tourist. He runs a used car lot up in Augusta.
Oh, I bet he does. Well, it's obvious he's an immigrant from New York. There are no native Jews in Maine. Just as there are no native Negroes here or native Puerto Ricans.
I wouldn't think so.
I'm just pointing out to Charlie some of the charms of his habitat. Some of the reasons why we like it here. We don't come for the bugs, you know. Of course, you do have your French Canadians. Oh, they speak French, which isn't quite as bad. Makes them sound intelligent.
Well, this particular dentist who's coming to celebrate your birthday is named Ray, and that doesn't sound Jewish.
Well, that would depend on the last name, I'd say.
That is his last name.
His last name is Ray?
Yes, Bill Ray.
Bill Ray. Sounds rather flippant.
Well, I think I should put this medicine away from all this hot air.
Why didn't you ever marry Chelsea?
You wouldn't let me.
Oh. Well, you could have married somebody else. I would have allowed it.
I didn't want anyone else. I mean, I've come close. There's still time.
Oh, yes, you've got plenty of time.
How old will you be?
When?
On your birthday.
103.
Really? Oh, sure, you're a kid. Yo, Miss Ackley was 97 in May. Isn't that amazing?
Yes.
She died, you know.
No.
Oh, yeah, last Tuesday. Oh. We got a call in case any mail come up.
They gave you a forwarding address for Miss Ackley?
Now, what's happening here?
Oh, one of the lesbians expired.
Which one?
Miss Ackley.
Oh, she had a good full life.
Charlie said she was 97.
Oh, well, that's wonderful.
Puts us all to shame, doesn't it? There's something to be said about a deviant lifestyle.
Oh. I always liked those old ladies, but I sure did used to wonder what the heck was going on up in there. Well, thanks for the coffee and the biscuits.
Anytime, Charlie. You must come around when Chelsea's here.
Well, yeah, I haven't seen her for a long time. Must be, well, let's see. It was the summer my father died, and I was 36 at the time. And I'm 44 now, so that's
8 years.
8 years. Holy macanoli. Well, see you tomorrow.
Yes, dear. Norman, Charlie's leaving.
Good.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Norman. Watch out for the screen door.
He really is a poop, isn't he? Have you seen our moons out there today?
Oh, yeah. Goodbye, honey. They're teaching the baby to fly.
Oh, I hope they bring him over to introduce us.
Goodbye, Charlie.
Bye.
Isn't that exciting? Teaching their babies to fly.
Listen to this. Elderly gentleman wanted for companionship and conversation for convalescing invalid. Doesn't that sound perfect?
Perfect for you. I wouldn't have much hope for the invalid.
Well, here's another one. Retired people's thought for handbill delivery. Mornings or evenings? I think I'll give them a call.
I can walk.
You'd be eaten alive by all those mosquitoes.
I'll bring my screen door with me.
Is that why you came rushing back here? To read those silly ads?
Could be. Maybe I should have asked Charlie. If he could use some help on that boat of his. I could balance on the deck and do a belly flop. Every dock we came into, it would be a source of amusement around the lake. It would be a boon for the postal department. Get people to write letters. I wonder how much he would pay me.
What in the world is wrong with you? Why do you need a job? You've always loved being on Golden Pond with nothing to do. What's so different about this year?
I'm in the market for my last hurrah.
Oh, God, for the love of God, Norman. Why can't you just pick berries and fish and read books and enjoy this sweet, sweet time?
So fast with my empty little bucket. When I got to the end of our lane, I couldn't remember where the old town road was. So I walked a little ways into the woods. Nothing looked familiar. Not one tree. And it scared me half to death. So I came running back here to you to see your pretty face and to feel safe and that I was still me.
Oh, Norman, you old poop, you're safe and you're still you. You're still putting on poor Charlie. After lunch, after we gobble up all our berries, I'll take you down to the old town road, and you'll remember it all, my darling. We've walked it a thousand times. And we'll pick another quart of strawberries. I'll do the bending, and you can just talk away those mosquitoes.
Thank you.
enough for celebration.
I just wanted to make our little girl feel welcome.
Yeah. Did you know that our little girl went through her childbearing years without bearing any children?
Yes. I know that. She chose not to, is all.
Doesn't that seem odd? Did you ever have that woman talk with her? You said you were going to. Maybe she didn't know how.
I told her how 25 years ago. She seemed to understand what I was talking about.
Well, maybe I should have taken that husband of hers aside. Boy, he could have used a few tips. I never met anybody so timid in my life.
Everyone she's brought home has been timid around you. You attack them so.
I don't, you know.
Wouldn't it be nice if we could all get along this time?
Oh, sure.
I wonder who I could talk to arrange that sort of thing.
Well, I intend to be the perfect host. I'll overwhelm them with my charm.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Well, why aren't they here already? I'm getting older by the minute.
They said they'd be here when they get here.
Is that what they said? Well, that's a hell of an attitude. No wonder we don't have any grandchildren.
What would we do with grandchildren?
Toss them on their knee. We're the end of the Thayers. The end of the line for a damn good name.
Well, we'll take it out in style. Oh, Norman, the loons. Oh, they're calling. I wish I could see them. Why is it so dark?
Because the sun went down.
Oh, I still wish I could see them. Oh.
Chelsea's companion, if I were you.
Nonsense. I'm just talking to my friends. Oh, dear. Oh, they're here, and I'm not dressed.
Well, you look dressed.
Oh, no. I wanted to look nice. I just look like an old character now.
Well, you are an old character. Run upstairs and change. I'll stay here and entertain them. I'll make them feel welcome.
Will you be nice to them?
Sure. I'll simply explain to them the risk involved in arriving late for an old man's birthday party.
Oh, Mommy!
Hi, Chelsea.
Hello, Norman.
Look at you.
Happy birthday.
Look at our little fat girl at home.
Norman, she's as thin as a rail, isn't she?
Yes.
Chelsea, I'm so glad you could come.
Oh, God, I thought we'd never get here. We rented a car that explodes every 40 miles.
You rented a car?
Yes, in Boston.
What? What sort of car is it?
Oh, I don't know. A red one, I think.
Oh, a red car.
No, I mean, what sort of make is it?
Oh, I don't know.
She doesn't know, dear. Doesn't matter.
Oh, of course it doesn't matter. I was just curious.
Well, I should have looked, I guess. It's very ugly, and it breaks down a lot.
Ugly and breaks down a lot. Sounds like a Saturn. I bet they bought up all the Saturns around the country, and now they're renting them to unsuspecting customers.
I'll bet.
I bet, too.
Well, okay. So, the old house looks exactly the same.
Well, the old house is exactly the same, just older, like its inhabitants.
Well,
what about your friend? You did bring your friend, didn't you?
Oh, I knew I was forgetting something.
Oh, that's still on, huh?
Well, as far as I know, it was 2 minutes ago. Huh. I may have been deserted. It wouldn't be the first time. Are you two ready?
Oh, yes, we can't wait.
Oh, yes, we can't wait.
Great. Hey, come on in. No one's gonna bite you. I hope. Mommy and Norman, this is Billy Ray.
How you doing?
Awfully young to be a dentist.
I'm a fast learner.
No, really?
This is Billy Ray Jr.
Oh, well, I'm Norman Thayer Jr.
His dad is out trying to sue the car.
This is such a nice surprise. Hello, Billy. You can call me Ethel, and you can call Norman Norman.
I like your logic, Mommy. I'm going to go see if Bill's gotten lost. He was trying to turn around, and he probably drove into the lake.
It's so dark out there. It never used to be this dark.
So, I hear you turned 80 today.
Is that what you heard?
Yeah, that's really old.
Oh, well, you should meet my father.
Your father's still alive?
No, but you should meet him.
This is such a nice surprise. Norman, why don't we put Billy up in Chelsea's old room and he could look out at the lake in the morning?
Why don't we put him on the float and he can look at the lake all night long?
I'd like that.
You'd be eaten alive by all the bugs.
So?
Norman, take him upstairs and put him, show him where everything is.
Come on, boy. Get your clutter.
I just had a birthday, too. I turned 13 2 weeks ago.
Why, we're practically twins.
We're 66 years and 50 weeks apart.
Oh, aren't we the smart ones?
Oh, yeah.
He's coming. Oh. He thought he had to lock the doors.
You can never tell with the changes around here.
Norman's looking very old.
Oh, well, I don't know.
Well, you look great, though. Oh,
well, thank you. So do you. Oh, I like your hair that way.
Oh, you do? Well, how's his mind? Is he remembering things any better?
Oh, he's just fine.
Come on, Billy. I'll show you the bathroom, if I remember where it is.
You made it.
Yes. I think I saw a bear.
I doubt that. Bill, this is my mother. Mommy, Bill Ray.
I'm so pleased you could come. Welcome to Golden Pond.
Thank you. Do you have a dog?
No. You know, I did try to interest Norman into getting a dog this summer, but he went into some morbid diatribe about how unfair it would be to get a puppy when you're just going to die.
Well, you could have gotten him an older dog, something on its last leg. Oh,
no, he's still in mourning for Chum, I'm afraid.
Bill, Chum is our golden retriever who passed on just 20 short years ago.
Oh, do any of your neighbors have dogs?
Well, no, I don't think so.
Then I definitely saw a bear.
I don't think you see a bear this time of year. They usually go pretty far into the woods when the summer people come. There are a lot of very nasty moths around, though. Sorry to say.
This was kind of big for a moth.
Probably a wild boar, then. Bill, do you want to go visit the men's room before you have to go through the shock of meeting my father?
No, I'm all right.
Oh, too late anyway.
Dad! They do have indoor clothing. Chelsea was bullshit.
Billy!
Well, I like to paint a rustic picture of life on Golden Pond.
Life is rather rustic here.
It's lovely, though. It has a lovely rusticity.
We've been peeing indoors for 40 years.
You must be Norman.
I must be. Who are you?
Bill Ray.
Bill Ray? The dentist?
Yes.
Want to see my teeth? Oh.
Norman!
I just want to say how glad we are to be here, sir. Chelsea talks about so much about you and your wife and your wonderful house here on the lake. And I'm just so pleased that she brought us.
Charlie's been asking for you.
Oh, Charlie. Holy Macanoli.
Yeah.
Charlie's our mailman. He was also my boyfriend every summer for 12 years. He taught me everything.
Isn't that amazing?
Not if you know Charlie.
Well, I'm going to go say hello to the lake. Anyone like to come?
Hey, I've never seen anyone say hello to a lake.
Well, then you're in for a valuable experience, wise guy. It's always my first order of business when I get to Golden Pond. Are you climbing, Mommy?
Yes. Would you like to take the boat?
Yeah.
Well, why not? Phil, let's go.
Where? Outside?
That's where the lake is. Are you coming, Norman?
Nope.
Come on, Norman.
No, I'm going to sit here and enjoy the quiet.
Well...
I think I'll stay, too.
Norman, come on.
Don't be silly. I'm going to sit here, enjoy the quiet, with Bill. We're going to talk baseball.
Great.
Great. Well, I'll get the door. Get the light here. I keep it off to discourage the June bugs. We're going to have to make a run for it. Ready? Okay.
So, you're a baseball fan, huh?
Nope.
Oh. I like baseball. I like the Dodgers.
Oh, really? They moved out west, didn't they?
Yes, to Los Angeles. Some years ago.
Ah. They still in the big leagues?
Oh, yes. They're a real powerhouse in the National League West.
Well, bless their little hearts.
So, how's it feel to turn 80?
It feels twice as bad as it did when I turned 40.
Oh, well, I know what that's like.
You do?
Yes. I turned 45 years ago. I'm 45 now. I love your house.
That's not for sale.
Oh, no, no, I wasn't thinking about buying it. I just like it.
Oh, so do I.
It has a charming ambiance.
Does.
Yes. Norman.
Yes?
May I call you Norman?
I believe you just did.
I don't want to press.
No.
I'll call you Norman then.
Fine.
And what shall I call your wife?
Well, how about Ethel? That's her name. Ethel Thayer. Sounds like I'm listening, doesn't it? She almost didn't marry me because of it. She wanted me to change my last name to hers.
And what was that?
I don't remember. Ethel is all you need to know. That's the name she goes by.
I never knew. Chelsea always calls her Mommy.
There's a reason for that.
But she calls you Norman.
There's a reason for that, too.
Huh.
Oh, I am her father, in case you're trying to figure that out. I'm her father, but not her daddy. Ethel is her mommy, and I'm Norman.
Hmm. Is it okay if I sit down?
It is, as far as I'm concerned. I think I'll get a book to read. Maybe I can finish it before I'm finished myself. Perhaps a novelette. Or maybe Reader's Digest condensed. Swiss Family Robinson. You ever read it?
Yes, it's great. I'd recommend it.
Oh, I know, I've read it too. But my mind is going, so it'll all be new to me. That son of yours, has he read this book?
I don't think so.
Your son hasn't read Swiss Family Robinson?
No, 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 but I intend to have him read it. I'm afraid his mother has been the motivating force in his life the last few years, poor kid. And now I'm making a move to eradicate some of the dishevelment. Things have been going pretty nicely for me lately. My practice is strong, and I'm feeling very good about myself. Meeting Chelsea has been a major thing. And she's really flowering. She likes her job a lot, and she's been doing some beautiful paintings. We have a very kinetic relationship. Very positive. I'm sure you'd be pleased.
What do you charge for a filling?
Huh?
You're a dentist, aren't you? What do you charge for a filling?
We start about $95.
$95? Good God! My brother charged $15 a filling up until 1988. Then he raised it to $20. That's when I stopped going to him.
Your brother is a dentist?
He was when he was living.
Isn't that amazing?
Well, I don't think so. I think all families have one.
Norman, I don't want to offend you, but there's a rather important little topic that I feel I have to broach.
I beg your pardon?
I don't want to offend you, but if it's all right with you, we'd like to sleep together.
What do you mean?
We'd like to sleep together in the same room, in the same bed, if you don't find that offensive.
All three of you?
What? No. No, just two.
Oh, you and Billy.
No.
Not Chelsea and Billy.
No, sir.
Well, it'd be Chelsea and you then.
Yes.
Well, why would I find that offensive? You're not going to do something unusual, are you?
No. Just, you know.
Well, it doesn't seem too offensive. As long as you're quiet.
Great.
Chelsea used to sleep with her husband in the same bed.
Oh, I'm sure.
Ethel and I do, you know. We've been doing it for years.
Well, of course, but you're married and all.
Well, so?
Well...
Starting to see it more clearly. It's a moral issue, isn't it?
It's just that we're of different generations, different mores.
What is a more? I've never known.
A custom, I'd say, or something.
Go on. Forgive me for interrupting.
Well, it's just a matter of point of view.
I shouldn't be interrupting.
Of course. It's just that I don't want a relationship to...
It's a serious social problem, I think.
Uh-huh.
Interrupting. Not listening. The art of conversation has gone with radio, probably.
Uh-huh.
Or maybe with mirrors. Uh-huh. Did you ever notice how people check themselves out in a mirror or window or in their eyeglasses when they're supposed to be listening?
Yes, I have noticed that.
It's a rather shifty quality, I'd say.
Yes.
Well, perhaps it's a form of egocentricity.
Yes.
I do it.
You do.
Sure. Conversation bores me to tears. I always look for a little divertissement while I'm waiting for my turn to talk. Rather shabby, huh?
Well.
Oh, but I never do it with Ethel. She's so pretty. Isn't she?
Yes, very pretty.
After all these years, I can't get over how pretty she is. And how handsome I am. That's why I always look for a mirror. I want to keep checking. Make sure I haven't faded. They say you fade with old age. They say your looks just go. I haven't noticed a thing.
No, indeed.
Now, what were we talking about? Sex, I believe. You were concerned about my morals wouldn't somehow mesh with yours.
Yes.
Don't be silly. I would be delighted to have you abusing my daughter under my own roof. Would you like to use the room where I first violated her mother? Or would you prefer the master bedroom? Ethel and your son and I can sleep out back. You can do it right here on the hearth. Like that idea?
You're having a pretty good time, aren't you? Chelsea told me all about you, about how you like to have a good time with people's heads. She does it too sometimes. And sometimes I can get into it. Sometimes not. You know, I just want you to know that I am very good at recognizing crap when I hear it. It's not imperative that you and I be friends, but it might be nice. I'm sure that you are a fascinating person. And I'm sure that it would be fascinating to get to know you. That's obviously not an easy task. But that's okay. You go ahead and be just as poopy as you want, to quote Chelsea. And I'll be just as receptive and pleasant as I can. But I want you to keep in mind while we're sitting here and you're jerking me around that I know precisely what you're up to. And that I can only take so much of it. Okay? Good. Now, what's the bottom line on the illicit sex question?
Another generation's mores. You seem like a very nice person. A bit verbose. A bit outspoken, but nice.
Thank you.
And you're right about one thing. I am fascinating.
I'm sure you are.
Well, now, I didn't mean to weigh down on our conversation. We can go back and talk about sex if you'd like.
No, that's okay.
Oh, I like talking about sex. You can ask me anything you want.
Well, I would like to have this little matter clear in my mind. Chelsea and I can sleep together, right?
Yes, by all means, of course. Just don't let Ethel catch you.
Dad, I paddle a canoe. It's a boat, just like the Indians have.
Hey.
Actually, the Indians used a different grade of aluminum.
Chelsea wants you to come down, Dad. She and Ethel are going skinny dipping.
Oh, skinny dipping, all right.
Oh, come on.
I don't know.
Permissiveness runs rapid up here on Golden Pond.
Are there ever any bears around these parts?
Oh, black bears and grizzlies. Why, it was just last month. One came along and ate an old lesbian.
Go on, Dad. He's bullshitting you.
Oh. God, I hope I live through these next few days.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's a good word.
You going skinny dipping?
No.
Are you? Nah. Try to be selective about who I flash in front of.
Huh?
Chelsea says you're a real heavy-duty fisherman. She calls you the old man of the sea.
Oh, I've caught a few. Do you fish?
No.
Would you like to go sometime?
Maybe.
All right. We'll see.
What do you think of your father? Tell you the truth, he's not bad.
Why do you walk with your shoulders bent like that?
Got a lot on my mind.
Oh. Well, what do you do out there in California since you don't fish? I mean, what does one do for recreation when one is 13 and not in school?
Cruise chicks.
Huh?
You know, girls. Eat them, try to pick them up.
Well, what do you do with them when you pick them up?
Suck face.
Yeah. I beg your pardon?
You know, kiss, suck face, kiss.
Oh, I see. Did you ever read that book, Swiss Family Robinson?
No.
Go read it.
Now?
Go read the first chapter and give me a report. Go on.
Well, I thought we were going to have a party.
I'll let you know when the party's underway, if it ever is. Now go on, read the first chapter. You'll like it. Come on, stand up straight. Nobody has that much on their mind. Ah, that's better. You should do that more often. It'll help you ease that heavy load of yours. Well, I thought you would be nude.
Well, sorry. The water feels lovely, but I didn't want to overwhelm Chelsea's friend on his first night here. Have you been picking on him?
Yep. Yes, I have. He finds me fascinating. He wants to know if they can sleep together.
I expected that. Well, I guess. They're big people, you know.
Yes.
We did, didn't we?
Yes. I told him.
Oh, dear Lord. I didn't have to tell him that. Oh, God, I guess I'll get some dinner on. I must be starved to death.
Oh, I am.
Where's the boy?
I sent him up to his room with a good book.
Well, Norman.
Yes.
There's something I want to do for Chelsea.
What?
Let her leave Billy here for the month.
Which Billy?
That young one, Billy.
Oh.
You know, Bill has him for the summer, and he would be miserable in Europe. And they could pick him up on the way back in August, and then it could be alone. Bill seems like a nice guy, and Chelsea needs someone nice. Couldn't we do that for her?
What would we do with him? What would I say to him?
Well, you think of something. Let's do it. Let's say we'll do it and give Chelsea some happiness.
All right.
Oh, Norman, I love you. We are going to have a splendid time, the three of us. You really are the sweetest man in the whole world, and I'm the only one who knows it. Well, I'll get dinner together. Huh? Can you hold out for 10 more minutes?
No, I'm going to bed.
Oh, no, you're not.
No, I'm not. I'm just bullshitting you.
Oh.